I don't think you can appreciate space until you walk through it. There are sizes which make us feel comfortable. There are views which make us feel comfortable. And this is a mixture of people who like both art and science. It's both sides of our brain. And so this pushes us into another whole area, which then is walking through an environment or the textures we like. And this is all part of design, which is exciting. And virtual reality and augmented reality is allowing us to get there, to explore those options before the building is built. I'm trying to really create new tools for designers for the 21st century. Today we've got an increase from the first computers, which is in the neighborhood of 100 trillion times more powerful than we had when we started. And so we really can do a lot more of our design inquiries in the very beginning and ask questions which we never dared to ask before, because we can get digital answers or simulation answers of things that we never thought we could identify. We can teach students how to design the new stuff, but I also have to be going to computer science and dealing with robotics and computer vision and the inverse of making a picture, which is where I got my start, is now let's take a picture and say what's in it and make sure that the construction, the as-built digital twin, is what we would get like we get an as-built digital twin in the space world or in the automobile world. Cornell is very fortunate in that we are such a diverse university between agriculture and engineering and arts and science and design and even public policy. And the elements are all here. And it is truly interdisciplinary collaboration. I just feel so fortunate. The thing is, if we teach people how to use these new tools, then the next generation will be in high demand by everybody and will be starting to change the way we deal with the profession.